Hey guys, what's up? Today I'm going to show you how to connect GitHub with Atom. Atom is a popular free source code editor for almost any programming language you can think of. I recently started learning Python again more in depth and wanted to save my projects with something like GitHub. I found it a bit difficult at first to find a proper tutorial that actually covered every step on how to connect GitHub with Atom. So I figured I'd create a quick video and show you what I found the easiest way on how to do it. There are two ways to connect GitHub to Atom. One is to create a repository within Atom itself and pushing it to your GitHub repository. Or two, creating a repository on GitHub and cloning it to Atom. I found the second method much easier, and that's what we are going to cover here. So first you need to create an account with GitHub, which is free. And then you want to go ahead and click New Repository to create a new repository in here. You can give the repository any name you like. I'll just call it Test Repo. You can give it a description, and the free account only allows you to create a public repository, so keep that in mind too. Click on Create Repository to create the repository. A couple of seconds later, the repository is already created, and you can see that you have a link to your repository, and also you have instructions on how to create a new repository on the command line, how to push an existing repository from the command line, or how to import code from another repository. We don't need any of that now, we just need to copy this small link over here. Alright, so we're gonna open up Atom again, and we're pressing Control, Shift and P at the same time, and we are going to enter GitHub, and it already pops up on the top, clone. And then you just click on this clone here, and you're gonna paste your GitHub repo link right here, and you click on clone. Takes a second, and then you see your test repo is popping up in here. And if we now would go ahead and create a new file, call it test.py, and it would be already green, indicating that it's recognized as a Git repository. The next thing we are going to do is we are going to authorize GitHub for Atom. So therefore, you're going to open a browser again, and you're going to go to the github.atom.io/login page. And you're just gonna do that right now. I'm not gonna pull this page open because my token will be revealed then, and I would need to blur out another picture in this video, which I don't want to do. So go there, log in with your GitHub credentials, copy the token, and we go ahead with the next step once you have done that. I'll put the link in the description as well to get to this page, so don't worry about that. You can just copy it from there. And I assume you have your token copied now. You go ahead and open Atom again. Open up the GitHub tab on the right lower corner, and I already entered my token. You will see a login button here and enter your token field, an empty enter your token field. Just paste your token in there and click on login. Then you should end up in the same window where I am now. Once you have that in check, we are going ahead and just for the heck of it, we are going to create another test file so I can show you two different options on how to commit something or how to push something to the repository. We call it test2py, and I'm gonna close all this rubbish here. So we have two files now. We have one which has a print hello everyone, and we're gonna have a second file which prints how are you doing, whatever, some bullshit. And then we are going to the GitHub. And now we can see up here that we have two unstaged changes. And first, save both files. Don't forget saving your files. I have to save it all the time. And once we click on that, we can see the changes that will be up for commit, basically. So here we see, how are you doing? And in the first file, we see, hello, everyone. How this works is you can either click on the stage all button to change or upload or push all files to the repository, or you can right click and just do one file. You can even exclude, I think, single lines of code, but you get the idea. You basically queue those files now for a commit. And because we're doing the first commit, I will just call this initial commit. You can call it whatever you want, version 1, version 0.1, whatever. And then click create detached commit. So now we didn't create a branch yet, so we have to click on master and we have to click on a new branch, and we just call it also main branch, or you can call it as your repository, whatever you want. Just click on it, and now we have the main branch in here, and then you want to click on publish, and eventually you get prompted again for your GitHub credentials. So just enter your GitHub account's email address and your GitHub account's password, and we can already see that this went away from here, those changes. The initial commit was done, and we can now go ahead and check this out on our GitHub account. Let's open up a browser again, go back to our GitHub repo, press the F5 button, and if we did everything correct, we should now see our two initial commits right here. We can open the file and we see print hello everyone, and the other file, sure enough, will present us with how are you doing. All right, so this is how you create, or how you connect GitHub with Atom. It can be a bit confusing if you do it for the first time. It certainly took me a while to get my head wrapped around it, but once you've did it, then it's pretty easy. I found it much easier than creating a repository out of Atom itself, because that would mean you need to download actually Git. As far as I understood, please correct me in the comments if I'm wrong, that you have to actually download Git, which we didn't do, and you have to kind of connect GitHub with your Windows computer to kind of make the initial commit. All right, guys, that concludes this tutorial. If you liked that, you know what to do. Give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. There will be more development stuff coming in the near future, because I'm working on Python, and I work on Python a lot at this moment. I really like the language, the simplicity of it, especially because I failed before at learning Java because it was just too strenuous for me. I tried to create an Android app, and after doing some Java, looking at Python was revealing, to say at the best. I really like Python. So expect more tutorials come from that side. Click on the notification bell to get notified about new videos, and thanks for watching.